Craig. Yeah. Leave a message at the tone. Unless you're my baby mother, then get the fuck out of here.
Yo, Kanye, bro, we got, yo, it's Kanye, bro. Yo, we gotta talk, bro. Yo, you talking about you crept down the block, made a right. That's where my son live, yo. You trying to hurt my family. You mad I took Balenciagas and took the Balenciaga off and called them Yeezy 350s. And you hating on me, trying to take food out of my family's mouth. Yo, you not picking up, bro. Yo, pick up, bro. Yo, Drake, man, stop texting Chris, bro. I'm sitting right next to him. I see the emojis, bro. Yo, stop playing with me, bro. Yo, bro, this is like the fourth time I left you a message, bro. Call me back, bro. You around the corner, I should just walk to your crib. Matter of fact, I'm gonna walk to your crib right now. I'm gonna walk past Larry David's crib on the way there and say, what's up? Fuck. Come on, man. I'm not gonna fight you on TV, bro. This is different. Call me, please. I love you. Do the fucking drop, man. This nigga's playing with me, bro. Yo, Trav, how you let him do me like this, bro? Do the drop. Someone take the boys.
I'm sad. A Calabasas heartbreak. Episode 138. Bodega Boys in the building. Coming to you live from the Jam Room in Melk Studios.
Which I mean,
it's your boy Desus Nice.
You know what I'm saying? The Kim Murder Human.
We're not gonna do the AKs from the beginning because AKs are now 2 hours long.
Yeah, stupid.
You could literally have them and have a baby and the baby be in first grade by the time they
That's
end.
Right.
Like, yo, my baby's doing Duolingo.
Yo, he got a 529 on deck.
Oh shit.
Yo, he's picking colleges.
Oh man. Another week. A lot has happened this week.
Yes.
Everything's happening so fast, it doesn't even matter.
Yo, Drake went from like Marshmallow Man to like
Drake runs
the
Calabasas.
Ultimate bully. Like he's the D-ball of Calabasas.
That's terrifying. Man, he's like, you get a late night call from Drake with a Jamaican accent.
Yo, what's a guan?
What guan?
Yo.
Yo.
Yo, run, you run. Yo, give me the red runners.
Man's is Marv.
Yo, don't cheese me, bro. Trust me, daddy.
But wait, how you got Drake? He got Kanye under pressure.
Fam, I don't know. Kanye
is so pushed to the edge. His only answer is to tweet it out in public in case Drake has something done to him.
Yo,
is Drake out here getting people killed?
Yo, first of all, I like how young Kanye tweets like my 60-year-old son text.
Mm-hmm.
Like he'll just
with a dash out of
words,
nowhere.
Like a dash, like what random emoji? Yo, bro. Period. Punctuation that doesn't make sense. Yo, man, your man went on a tirade last night, bro. Like.
See, at first I was like, is this the pills? Because, you know, anytime Kanye
when he's off the Lexapro.
Yeah. But then I was like, I don't know, like,
listen,
shouldn't he just fight? He should just fight Drake, right?
How are they going to fight? Bro, imagine them fighting in Calabasas. Like,
yeah.
And like an orthodontist comes out and like, hey,
Kanye's like 40 with four kids. Like,
come on, fam. With orange hair.
This is next door beef. This is something you see and you watch it from your window. Like, hmm.
Oh, shit.
That's why it used to be a nice community before they moved here.
Oh. You get that app that like you type in crime and shit, like the snitching app. Like,
right away, take a picture.
Black man fighting here.
Also, you can't report it because you don't know what race Drake is at the moment. He's Jamaican.
I think he's
Dominican.
Irish. He's Jamaican, Dominican, the Irish. I think. I don't know. I'm not sure. Man, it's every flag emoji.
Listen,
every flag emoji is in his current emojis. Like recently used emojis, all of them.
He's just out here, man. He's just trying to make music for everybody.
That's it, bro.
In other news, the president sniffs Adderall, and it's not that big a deal.
That's it.
Yo, Barack wore a tan suit. That nigga was on his ass for months.
Listen,
he been headed out here like get that pure.
Let me tell you something. Have you ever had to study for a test late at night? Mm. Come on, give me a break here.
Yo, shout out all my NYU students.
Yo, like, shout out to the Tisch Academy.
Mm-hmm. Chop it up right, you get those real hard pieces.
You know what I'm saying? That shit gets stuck in your fucking sinus cavity.
Ooh.
Keep you up for days, motherfucker.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. Ain't nobody out here sniffing Adderall.
No drug use. We don't do drugs at all.
All right, no one said all that. We just said allegedly about that. Let's not paint ourselves in a corner here. All right, just want to be in front of everything.
The Showtime drug show host claimed to not do drugs. Here's a picture of Mero smoking angel dust.
There's literally a photo of us with like a 10-foot blunt on Venice Beach. We can't get away from that, jumping in front of that, in case the Oscars wants us to host.
You know what I'm saying?
We don't want it.
We don't want it. Shit is like hot potato.
Yo, right now, what's the worst job? Working for Trump or hosting the Oscars?
Fam.
Because right now, either one is like, I'll see.
Fam, I'd rather be Chris Brown's publicist.
Damn.
Like, that's how real it is.
Is that even a real job?
Nah, it is now.
I think Chris Brown just uses Google auto replies and shit. decide if he's going to locations and shit.
He got Google Earth for himself. He's like, what do I do now?
He's like, what?
Oh, shit. Nigga smoking a Newport 1000.
Wait, I'm banned from CBS because what? They're like, you chewed
Remember you threw the chair.
It's like, that wasn't me.
That wasn't me.
They got the footage. He's like,
oh, shit. Damn.
Nigga pop and lock out of it.
Ryan Seacrest ducked by under the coffee table and shit without ducking.
Damn, Chris Brizzy.
Yeah, man. He's
King of R&B?
That's what they were saying. Like, listen, there's
nah,
a lot
come
of
come on, say with your chest. You
there's
can't.
There's
don't,
a lot of kings of R&B. I threw in the king for David.
You can't
Caesar.
Have. Oh, you can't have a bunch of kings of R&B. There's one king.
There's one king. There can only be one.
There can only be one. Who's your king of R&B? Some washed dead person.
Oh man. I mean, like that's a comp. There's layers to that question. Be like, what kind of R&B are we talking about? Are we talking about like neo soul? You know what I'm saying?
Just R&B.
Are
we talking about like why is it getting so nuanced?
Where we get into like subgenres and shit. Mm-hmm. Like I threw on the cape for Daniel Caesar. And people were like, "Word, yo, shout out to him."
Then Daniel Caesar.
Yeah, like that was a deep cut though. Like
that's
you know
like
what I'm
like
saying?
A deep cut. He's like, he's been around for like 3 months. Like, shout out to Daniel Caesar, the homie.
Shout out to the guy. He's nah, really soulful though. His vocals are soulful.
The king of R&B is Trey Songz.
That's true. Yo, because he invented sex. He did.
He invented like finger pop R&B.
Yeah, he did. I'm a finger you in the club, like, girl.
When you giving that girl that fake massage,
yeah,
you're just gonna roll for like 2 minutes.
Like a
your hand cramp up. You're like, let me just whip it out.
It's like a Brazzers scene where you put the thumb in the butt by accident. Like, oh shit! Oh,
I don't know what Brazzers is.
You don't know? Oh no, no. We don't do drugs. We don't watch pornography.
How do you access that to the Bible app? Because I was at home last night reading Galatians 4.
You use a proxy.
And I said to myself, "What would Ja do in this moment?"
God bless.
There's an alternate Jesus, so we're riding the train and annoying the fuck out of people.
Read the scriptures and shit. Yo, my
it's not
God.
As fun.
Yo,
we just got the Bible Boys. The concerts are sold out, but it's just like a lot of women with long skirts.
Yes.
A lot of guys with the super cut haircuts.
Yo, move your hat, yo. Try to see.
No one's saying yo. It's like a kingdom hall. It's like very like, everyone khakis.
Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. Would you pass the microphone to the brother, yes. Brother Jesus?
Hey, thank you. Hey. Just want to talk about what the Lord did for me today.
Oh, thank you. We will all meet in paradise one day.
Don't forget, guys. We're gonna have that Bodega Boys Super Church coming soon.
Ooh, get ready, y'all.
The showtime didn't work out.
Oh, that mega church is getting
mega church.
Ooh, we're gonna be on a plane like do the Millie Rock on a Jeep on a PJ,
eating Matt FEMA supplies and shit. We're gonna have a distilled water fight. You kids want this?
Oh, sorry.
They got a FEMA camp making ASMR videos. This water's
delicious.
No, we would always creepy. Help the poor.
Yeah, of course. We do the bodega bug shit. Like
we're poor though, right?
We're poor.
We're poor in God's eyes.
We're poor. Yes, we're very poor. I'm so poor. I'm so poor. Like
how much is milk?
Like $4.
I'm lactose intolerant.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You should ask me how much is oat milk.
That right there? That distinction?
Like
okay, because if you go in my local supermarket and you ask for oat milk, you get chased out with a bat.
What kind of hip hop?
Oat milk.
Does Whole Foods take ABC?
Yeah.
They do, right?
Yeah.
Oh, so yeah, let's get it.
I'm
with the schemes.
You can't get arrested for like welfare fraud.
At this point,
this is
we got a Showtime show coming out.
I don't know much about TV contracts, but I'm 1,000% sure there's a clause in the Showtime contract where if you get caught arrested for welfare fraud, I'm doing a show by myself.
I'm doing the wall perp walking shit. Yo, call David Nevins, B. Call David Nevins, yo. Stop
you gonna do all
me.
Your scenes from? We gonna Skype you from Rikers?
Just mad pork chops falling out my pants and
shit.
Like,
you trying to record tonight? Tekashi interrupts.
He's like, yo, what you doing at? I'm like, yo, fam. There's other people in his dorm. It's like 3 a.m. trying to sleep.
Do you think
the
he's
fuck?
Still talking? I think he's very quiet now.
Oh, I think he's very quiet.
It's probably just him with his Bible.
Yeah, just him and his Bible. He cut all his hair off. He's chilling.
Jesus with the vagina.
Yo, praise the Lord.
Actually, now would be not a bad time to be in jail because you got Tekashi in there.
Yeah.
You got Bobby Schroeder.
You can drop a fire album in jail right now.
Enjoyable. You're the only people who are trying to tell y'all to go to jail.
You go to jail. Drop a video to get some features.
Yo, Department of Corrections, cut that check.
Yo, go to jail for clout.
Yo. It's like, yo, let's be honest. Y'all not doing nothing here on the streets.
It's like every commercial.
Same thing every day. You wake up, you watch Jerry Springer.
That's right.
Yo, You're a burden on your mother.
Come on now.
Don't you want three meals guaranteed?
Three hots in the cot? Mm-hmm. Come to Rikers.
I did it. You can do it too. Bring your kids.
Can you bring your kids? A luxurious boat cruise.
You can't bring it. You get arrested with your kids.
Yeah, that's true.
That's sadder though.
That's wild sad.
Cause like it'd be cool, but then when you in a holding cell and you like, oh shit, that's your father.
Why you dancing on the toilet?
Niggas violate you in front of your father?
Niggas a herb.
Oh shit.
Just dump you and shit. Your son's like, wow, you wild buns pop. You're like, damn, son, I'm sorry.
Oh, nigga smack your father in jail?
Yo.
Damn.
That's it.
That's a very traumatic situation. That's also a very hilarious CBS sitcom.
My dad got smacked in jail.
My felon dad. It's me and Ray Liotta back to back, like, yo. Dad, now's not the time to stop smoking.
Ray Liotta's like, what are you talking about? I can't.
Jesus, pass me my Chantix.
I tried to quit, but I couldn't, you know? I mean, I can't move my face anymore. Because, you know, the things in my face, I got surgeries a lot. You know, like
what is that, fillers?
Fillers. Is it fillers? I don't know. I mean, I live in Jersey now, so I see a lot
of
that.
Yeah, let me know. Hook me up.
You know what I'm saying? Get some Botox.
Let's get our lips done. We got to get our lips done for the Showtime show. We got to have the wild duck lips. I'm going to look like I'm British. Like,
yeah. Come on.
Sip, y'all.
We bring it back to Kylie Jenner challenge and shit. Yeah. Just like shatter a fucking jar on my face.
I forgot that was it. How long ago was that?
That was the thing. Listen, white kids do a different thing every week. It's a different thing every week. First it was Kylie Jenner, then they were eating cinnamon, then they were lighting themselves on fire.
Wow, the cinnamon challenge.
Yeah, remember that? They will light themselves on fire too.
And you know what? Because the internet moves so fast, that feels like that was 20 years ago.
Yeah. Tide Pods.
Tide Pods, yeah.
I put a Cascade Pod in my dishwasher yesterday because I'm poor. And I was just like, wow, this is going to be the next thing. This is going to be it.
I'm calling
it right now. Yeah, Cascade Pods are going to be the new Tide Pods. They're gonna start
but Cascade Pods been around.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So there's no...
They're going to be like, yo, oh, we can't eat Tide Pods? Because you know white kids are mad defiant. They're going to be like,
I think Tide Pods came and went. You got to...
Had a moment, but
it
came and went.
They're on to something else now.
We have some new
Tide Pods, and you get a chance to fully cook. Because then remember people comment, like Gronk came out and was like, don't eat Tide Pods.
Yo, if Gronk got to tell you not to eat Tide Pods...
But that kind of made you want to eat the Tide Pod. Yeah, like, that's a fact. Anytime someone tells you not to do something, you're like,
oh, word?
Why?
Why should
you turn
I?
Into like a curious 4-year old? Like, huh? What? Why can't I touch the stove?
Why not? Mm-hmm. Oh my God, I can't. Oh, that's why.
But you're going to touch it again later in life.
That stove is Tide Pods, motherfucker.
Yo, remember clowns? Remember when clowns were everywhere?
That was a thing?
Yes. The whole country was terrified. Like,
oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, the killer clowns.
No, not killer. It was just clowns.
It was just clowns running around?
Yeah. Just like, killer clowns is a whole other thing.
I think that's a movie franchise. That's
an excellent movie, which we should also bring back.
You know what I'm saying? Killer clowns from outer space, when they shoot motherfuckers and they turn into confetti. You know what I'm saying? Remember that?
Spoiler. Yeah. I mean,
spoiler alert.
Our millennials as they see them. Oh.
This shit is on Netflix. Is that the Netflix for having terrible horror movies that I watched smacked.
And good anime is like Neo Yoko.
Yeah.
Pink Christmas. Be sure to check that out.
Yeah.
Now available starring Jada Smith and the boys.
Got Lee Lexi in the building. Holla.
Just all our money out the window with Mero.
I said terrible horror movies. The anime is strong. You know what I'm saying? The anime is strong.
As is the brand. You don't even watch anime. Name five anime films.
Gundam Wing, Death Note, Ninja Scroll, Dragon Ball Z, the other one.
I feel like giving you the wild wedgie right now. Catch you outside of school. Like, hey, nerd, give me your Magic the Gathering cards.
Give me your acid jerk.
While you run for the 4-chain.
Like, no! Oh, memories. Because, as you know, I went to Glenn High School, and Bronx High School was right there. Mm-hmm. Chase a lot of kids to the 4-train, you know what I'm saying, for their Pokemon cards.
Sad. Why would you do that?
Because they had the holographic joints, you know what I'm saying? I didn't have the holographic joints. She was real.
That's what you were doing in your youth in the Bronx?
Smoking angel dust and playing Pokemon.
Okay. I was sponsoring wayward kids.
Like me?
And I was helping clean the Bronx River. Had a big net.
Yeah, shout out to the Bronx River because it's 2 inches deep and there's like 48 tires in it.
No, they cleaned it up now. It has a... Damn, I forgot it has a mascot now, a beaver. Oh, Juan the Beaver?
Juan the Beaver?
Listen.
He's like the...
I'm not, I'm not racist. I'm just saying why we gotta have an ethnicity for the beaver.
Papi, I hate because and the super the river.
I mean, for all my good white people that were living in the Bronx in the 50s, like why his name can't be like David the Beaver?
Dave the Beaver.
You know, it used to be a good river. Now we got
you know there's a fucking you know
it's clean, but now the fucking beaver got the big Puerto Rican flag and shit. Like yo, he's not there during the parade.
He's just mad empty cans of Coors Light everywhere.
Shout out to Juan the Beaver.
Shout out to Juan the Beaver.
We get him on the show. Yeah. You could kill him and have him in the background on the Showtime show. Like we could.
Put a hat on him. A tiny little hat.
That might not resonate with the Bronx residents. But most people don't even know we have a beaver as a beaver. Resident.
They're just finding out right now, bro.
I don't even think the beaver knows either.
But he don't know. He's just there. He's just drunk off Coronas. He got lost and shit. He went to La Marina once and got lost.
Speaking of La Marina, moment of silence. One of the greatest clubs that, one of the greatest parking lots covered in sand is no longer going to be open for us to party and purchase illegal drugs.
They lost their license.
La Marina.
Damn.
I mean, it got closed down with mad health violations and they were selling drugs in it.
Also, but hey, you know what I'm saying? But listen, what's a health code violation, really? True. At the end of the day, you know what I'm saying?
Health code violations are weird because it's more about your, you know, your immune system.
You know what I mean?
If anything, like
if I see a C, I'm like, yo, this is gonna help me build my immunity.
There you go.
You know what I'm saying? To foodborne illnesses. You know what I'm saying?
You go. See, because I mean, if you eat street meat, if you've lived in New York long enough and you've ever had like a gyro or something, you can eat anything.
Anything, fam.
I'll go to a restaurant. I didn't even wash the dishes. I'll be fine. You're not getting E. coli. You're not getting nothing.
You don't gotta wipe the table down. Nothing. Just, yo, let me rock.
Here's a hint. If you have a child, make them lick the poles on the subway.
Yeah, and the windows on the
bus. That's how you get, what is it, herd immunization?
Yeah. That's hood vaccines.
That's it.
If you're anti-vax, but you're in the hood, like, just lick a window on the
problem
bus.
With anti-vax, it sounds cool.
Yeah.
It sounds really cool.
It sounds bad cool.
Like, you won't be down with that.
Until Jenny McCarthy's like, hey guys, don't vaccinate your children. They'll die. They'll die. They'll die.
That seems like such a weird thing to just be like, that sounds like something my parents would have gotten into because it would have been like, vaccinations cost how much?
$5?
You know, we'll pay for it when he gets sick.
You're bad, right? get chicken pox once, that's it.
Anti-vax, you don't vaccinate your kids for anything?
Period.
Wow.
Nothing.
And none of you didn't do it with
hell,
like just,
I'm not an idiot.
You didn't do it with just one of your kids just to see?
No. I'm like, yeah.
Just like a sample shirt?
You're the safety. No, I do got four. I got four, but it's like, I'm like, I want four of y'all to live. It's like a raffle ticket. You know what I'm saying? Every one of my kids is a raffle ticket. I'm like, one of y'all is going to win me something. You know what I'm saying? I want a fucking return on my investment, baby.
I mean, what kind of raffle are we talking here? We talking about, like, playing the MLB or, like, the local church's spaghetti dinner. Like,
you want an iPod first generation. Here you go. Yo, with no charger.
All right. Well, shout out to you for getting vaccinating your kids. I guess that's something you congratulate people for now.
Like I halfway did it because I did like half dosages.
You have your kids on vaccination layaway?
Yeah, pretty much. Exactly. Yeah, true. Like true story. Like half the shot now.
You're like gonna go put $3 on the measles. Like yo, shorty, I got you with that rubella next week.
Yo, listen, I got the mumps. I got half of the mumps. I got my final payment for the measles.
Explain, how do you have them halfway?
Because of the whole anti-vaccination craze, like, you know what I'm saying? People are, like, nervous. So it's like you can ask to get a dose of the vaccination and then and see how it affects your kid and then come back and get the other half.
So basically you, with absolutely no experience ever studying medicine, go and tell a professional
to
cut a dose in half?
No, the doctor.
So you can see shit?
The pediatrician was like, yeah, like, everybody's doing it now.
I would take the dose and kick your whole family out of my office. Like, get the fuck out of here. I went to school for 8 years. You're not going to tell me.
You're not going to tell me what the dose
is. So you have a Yankee logo on the jersey. Get the fuck out of here. Wow.
I just put my highlight. Yo, listen, yo, just give me like a quarter of that measles. Like a quarter.
They can order vaccinations off the menu. Let me get a motherfucking, y'all got vaccine gyros?
Y'all got polio?
Oh, shit.
Y'all got polio vaccines?
Do they still do polio vaccines? We beat that, right? Is that the last disease we beat?
Is it a rap for polio?
No, they said it was coming back. Like some people, because they're not vaccinating the kids. So now polio's coming back. Polio.
See? Stupid. Fucking idiot. Now my kid got Zika because of your kid.
I don't think Zika.
No?
It's not Zika. Zika's not what we used to worry about, but now it's just like polio and measles.
I can't even keep track of this shit, bro.
Well, you're a fan. You got to. I'm the one that don't need to keep track of this shit.
It's too much.
Like, if I get polio, I just got to make some phone calls. Like, yo. Remember the other night at Output? Yeah. You might want to check yourself for rickets.
Yeah.
Supreme is doing a crutch drop soon. You know what I'm saying? You can use those.
Supreme did a crutch drop. You know what I mean? Supreme still got time to come out with an iron lung.
Let's get it.
That would be... I'll wait a lot for that.
Who's the boss of Supreme? Dude, yeah, there you go. That's your new shit.
Is that the Supreme is that the end game?
Supreme Iron Lung.
We bring him back. We're not vaccinating our kids, so we can get the Supreme Iron Lung. Supreme. That seems like a bit of a stretch, but
I got,
you know,
Supreme nebulizer on deck. You know what I'm saying? I got Supreme sleep apnea machine.
We gotta stop making sleep apnea jokes. So what DM'd me, it was like they were funny in the beginning, but
you gotta chill. My man got sleep apnea. He was like, "Yo, you think that shit's funny, nigga?"
You know, it's a lot of work. Cause I thought it was just you just strapped up. You gotta like clean the mask.
Yeah, like, bro. My man's wife was like, "Yo, I gotta roll this motherfucker. I gotta turn this motherfucker. The mask be coming off and shit." Like, I'm like, "Oh damn, I didn't know it was that serious, bro."
My biggest fear is like something that we mock on this podcast. One of us gets. People gonna let us have it, boy.
And now
when we watch the MSNBC and I'm doing those sleep apnea commercials, and I got the wild hoop earring.
Yeah, I'm just sitting right next to you with the two fucking.
It's me, you, and Montel Jordan. Like, yo, this is how we breathe now.
This is how we breathe out. Sniffing at a raw.
Oh, sad.
Damn, bro. It's sad. It's sniffing at her own sad.
Is it? Was that ever like cool?
It's never cool to sniff. Adderall is like, yo, I got a paper due in 10 hours.
Yeah, and Adderall doesn't even work like that. You just sniff it and it's like, not a fucking can of spinach, you know, Popeye. It's not gonna like have you out here.
Come on, yo, bro. You're not in the club like. Follow me. Adderall, yeah.
No. But, I mean, a good blast of Adderall will have you putting all your t-shirts in your color fucking Roy G. Biv, and you open your car and like, whoa,
go through the garbage, putting the tags back on the shirts.
You fucking taking off the keys on your keyboard, putting them in alphabetical order, still sending emails. That's a good time. A little Vyvanse action there.
A little Vyvanse. Oh,
my God. You're calculating the RBIs of the baseball game by hand. 351.
Turn into Jonah Hill and Moneyball and shit. Like, yeah. Spin out mad stats. Like, yo, what's wrong with this
Vegas
motherfucker?
Counting cards and shit. Not even sleeping. Like, Yeah.
Yo, Vyvanse will keep you awake for 6 weeks.
Vyvanse, those are supposed to be, like, the more responsible.
The responsible, yeah.
Like, it's like a doctor gave these to you. Yeah.
No. I mean, a doctor also gives you Adderall.
It's a different doctor. Like, a doctor that's just giving you Adderall, you might be next to someone with a gunshot wound. Like, yo, shit, it's like private practice and shit.
Shout out to all the doctors you just go to and you're like, yo, just give me this. And they just give you that.
I think those days are over. It's not how it used to be. You can't just be getting like.
They
got the database now where anytime that you get any kind of prescription drugs, they have to check if you already have a prescription.
Yeah.
Says you have to bust out the extra social security numbers.
Yeah. Like,
name is Raul Guantanamo.
Guantanamo. Yeah.
I have a sciatica, so I'm going to need a couple opioids, my guy. No, they denied me, I think, Tylenol 2.
What?
I was very embarrassed.
Like, wow.
It was the dentist. And I was like, after a root canal, it was like, you want, like, and I was like, sweet, I'm going to need something stronger.
Tylenol 2?
I was like,
for a root canal?
I was like, you got like Tylenol 6? Like, so how does this shit work?
Is the two like an exponent? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
and Tylenol 2 is like what they give kids in Canada. So.
Fam, this shit is over the counter in Canada.
Well, they don't really have counters and shit. They got like barrels.
It's over the moose in Canada. Yo, shit.
They're like, ha, that's very funny. You guys have no health insurance.
Like, I'm like, damn, bro.
I was like, damn, they got us.
Yeah, he's like, damn.
Just Norm laughing at us.
And our leader is way sexier than yours. He's like, damn, you got that too. Damn, you're right.
Yeah, Justin Trudeau, he's a looker.
He's a looker. He's dreaming. Yeah. He got like white guy movie star hair. You know what I'm saying? Like, he could be a leading man.
Justin Trudeau looks the way Donald Trump thinks he looks.
Yeah.
When he looks at himself in the mirror, he probably does that thing where he flexed the pecs. Yeah. Like, yeah.
Yeah, look at that. Look at
presidential.
This. Yeah.
MAGA.
Beep the bounce. Terry Crews in his bitch.
So wait, he's been paying women. He's paying women just to say he never slept with them, or not to get the, what is it?
The
BDR, the bad dick report.
Yeah, you don't want the BDR.
You don't want the bad dick report.
Because you know he's giving the wild, weak coke dick. Yeah. That weak-ass Adderall dick.
He probably still got the tie on. Oh, Adderall. Yeah, he got the Vienna sausage out.
My man just down there eating the ass for 2 hours.
Trying to make something. Anything happens. Come on.
He keeps asking, is it good? How's that?
I gotta go through this. This nigga wiggling it.
Wiggle it just a little bit. Come on, come on, come on.
Come on, come on. Don't do this to me. Don't do this to me.
Come on.
All right, Donald, get out your head.
Come on.
You're overthinking it. Jeff You're overthinking it.
Jeff Sessions already disappointed
Relax.
Me. Don't disappoint me, too.
Think about the beach. Think about the beach. Think about the beach. Okay, calm waves, calm waves. Calm
Ivanka,
waves.
Ivanka, 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 Ivanka.
All right, no stress, no stress. She's not looking at you. She's not looking at you.
She's looking at him like, yo, like, get
what are you doing?
She's looking at the clock like, God damn, when is this shit going to be over?
I'm about to tweet about this guy.
Why are you holding your dick while you fucking me, my guy? Like, what is wrong with you?
Oh, he's doing the he's pushing rope?
He goes, like, you riding a horse and shit? Like,
how does that feel? Yeah. Yeah.
You call that the city slickers.
Yeah.
Got thrown a Mets jersey.
Yeah, I learned this from Billy Crystal.
Now you put the image of Billy Crystal having sex in my head.
What does Billy Crystal look like now, dog? The last image I have in my head of Billy Crystal is him like at a Yankee
Billy
game.
Billy Crystal definitely looks like he was in New York in the 80s.
Okay.
That's how he looks.
Okay. Copy
That's
that.
The most accurate description I can give you.
Yes.
Man.
If you don't know what that means, just Google it.
Billy Crystal, a New York legend.
Yes. Google Billy Crystal 2018 and see what he looks like.
Oh, me? No.
You, motherfucker. We're not doing all the work. You do some work. Go Google Billy Crystal, 2018, what he looks like right
we
now.
Giving people totally homework and shit?
Yes.
Nah, they just trying to enjoy
That's
a
it.
Podcast.
No, this is work, motherfucker. We got to do work. Fuck out of here. Think I woke up at 7 a.m. just for entertain you motherfuckers? Fuck out of here. Tired of this shit.
Are you gonna quit?
No, imagine.
We gotta talk.
I just
about
start
something?
Tweeting and shit like, "Yo, Jesus, man, we gotta talk, man."
Yo, can I just ask you if we ever have beef? Let's not do it on the timeline.
I got okay? you. I got you.
Because the first tweet,
we'll do it like
if true. I ever see a tweet and it's like DJ talking to me, I'm gonna pick up the phone like, "Motherfucker, what's
yeah,
wrong with you?
What's wrong with you? Nigga? You're fucking up the bag, motherfucker."
You know how many phone calls you're gonna get? A call for Showtime, Sherry, Victor, everyone, people we don't even work with anymore, Juice Box, everyone's calling. Yeah, you know Shade Room's gonna have that like T-Report
to comment creeping. Mero leaves funky emojis and Jesus is like DM. Oh my god.
Don't try to block you. Start going under your old post and playing pictures. Like, yo.
If we ever had beef, I would do it like a true West Indian and just leave you 20 WhatsApp voice notes.
I'd be like, nah, I'm not answering this shit.
And just I just see the double check and be like, damn, you read the shit. Fucker.
Damn.
Send me a barrel.
So we should we avoid getting on Drake's bad side?
Yes.
Damn.
Apparently yes, because he will Drake fuck
runs,
you up.
Drake runs tings?
He runs tings. Tings are on him.
Hmm.
Your best, you know, I'm not wrong.
Oh, Kanye said Drake paid for 200 seats at Pusha T's concert.
Oh, he did the job. He did the 50 jobs?
But then he had like people there, and that's why they were throwing the water, and it hurts his soul.
Wow.
This is all really messy. It's all really messy and really catty.
Wow.
Remember when beef, like rap beef, people would die?
Yeah. Like or at now, least freestyle.
Yeah, now people just like stealing people's Amazon packages from their fucking door and shit. Just giving a middle finger to their Nest like, camera. Like, ah,
fuck
ah,
you.
Take that.
Take dickhead.
I know you're watching.
Ah. Or the seamless to your crib. Ha.
Ha. Enjoy that wonton soup. And I didn't tip him. I left you on the bag for that.
Drake steals Kanye's Uber and shit. Like Uber driver's like, Kanye? Drake is like, yes.
Yeah.
It's ruthless. He didn't even care where he's going. He's like, we're going to Santa Monica. I don't care.
Kanye standing there like, how'd the ride start already?
You fucking mosquito.
Oh. Wait, is Uber evil this week?
Is it?
Because like every other week, we find like Uber would be really good for like a week, and then it'll be something really bad. Yeah. Like they open a hood and actually kids in there instead of an engine.
It's
really
it's like Flintstones, it's like just mad little toddlers.
They're like free me. Like, that's enough. That's enough. We go. Like, oh shit.
Yo, stop. We got to pull over. I got to get some more Go-Gurts.
I love how we pretend that Uber, Lyft, and all the other ones are all different.
Yeah, no, they're
and
not.
And they're just all the same rides.
Yeah, Lyft just got the little cute mustache, so you're like, oh, there's...
They don't really have the...
They're
they don't have the cute mustache anymore. They just have, like, the pink light, the guy's just mad, disgruntled.
Yeah. He just flips the sign over to Uber anyway, or to Juno, or to whatever the
and
fuck
some
else.
Of these drivers are not low. Sometimes you could tell they've just been driving around all day farting in the car.
Yo, fam.
Because there's no reason for the car to smell like that.
Fam,
that's not a natural smell.
Fam, you got a leather interior and it's smelling
fart?
Window,
man.
Like, come on, dog, you got a sunroof.
That's not a normal.
Shit.
Usually a smell is like taps you on the shoulder, like,
nah.
Hi.
That shit,
how's
as soon
going?
As you get in the car, it's like, just grab you by the nose, like,
yo,
smelling shit.
This is, your rating going down right now. You should have a smell rating at Uber. Yeah, because it could be a five-star trip.
Five-star trip, excellent farter.
But you know, you get in there, he's eating some baba ganoush, you know, get a couple extra puffs on the BQE. Every time he hits a bump, it's like,
I respect the Uber driver that just farts like blatantly and doesn't give a fuck.
Yeah, but then those are the ones that get too comfortable, start running red lights and shit.
Listen, sometimes you need that. Sometimes you run 10 minutes behind.
You don't want your Uber driver to be, just because your Uber driver is reckless with their life. I didn't sign up for all that, okay? I don't want to have to do that move where after, like, he goes through one red light, I have to, like, slowly put my seatbelt on, but not loud enough, so he hears it, like, yo, this nigga trying to kill me. All right.
Just pretend you put your book back down, like,
He just sees you, he makes eye contact with the mirror. You all right, boss?
You all right?
You all right? Everything back there?
Yo.
Temperature good?
Papi, okay?
What type of music you want to listen to?
Why you put seatbelt? You
look like a hip-hop nigga. What's up?
Papi, you scared? You nervous?
Oh, you start using, like, the fucking handle on the door? Like, oh, shit. That's what
the
shit is.
Oh, shit. This nigga got the child lock on. Fuck. You can't even drive and roll and shit. Like,
he drops the car on, like, a pothole and then apologizes to the car by hitting the dashboard. Like, oh, sorry, baby.
Yeah, I'm
like,
sorry.
No. Why are you doing 70 on a residential street?
Come on, fam. In a Hyundai Sonata? Mm. Like, come on. You're doing too much.
I just thought we would probably be Uber drivers if we didn't have a podcast.
Abso-fucking-lutely.
Yeah.
Abso-fucking-lutely.
And not good ones either.
Terrible ones, fam.
Not following the GPS and shit.
Yo, you know how to go? Where you going?
Where you going? They got a Second Avenue in Brooklyn?
What?
Chill. You learn something new every day.
Oh, shit. That's crazy.
Like, Hold on. I got to. Yo, I'm going to Second Avenue in Brooklyn.
Yo, this is crazy. Yo,
that's what I said.
Yo, peep it, yo.
Yo.
Look at this shit.
What's up?
Yo.
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 Yo, you like hip-hop? I made some beats. I could do the ad-libs for you.
Yo. Yo. I actually had an Uber driver, because I was smoking it. I was like, yo, can I smoke in the car? Because I smelled
bold.
I smelled smoke in the car. So I was like, you smoking? He's like, yeah. It was like, dude was like 20-something. He's like, yeah, you can smoke. So I'm smoking. And he's like, yo, you smoke butt? I was like, yeah.
Wait, what were you smoking? And he asked if you were smoking bud.
I was smoking a cigarette.
Oh, you were smoking that's okay.
Because I smelled bud. So I was like, all right, this is like,
got
you. You know what I'm saying? So I'm smoking a cigarette. And then he's just like, yo, what kind of music you into? I was like, oh, shit, here we go. I was like, yeah, like hip hop, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I grew up on like Medanga and shit like that. He's like, yo, I got a tape, yo. You want to listen to this shit? I'm like, we're in the Lincoln Tunnel. Like, I'm like, what am I going to say? No?
Like, imagine you reject it. Like, like 20 minutes left on it?
Not really, fam.
Nah, not feeling it.
We're an hour away from my destination, but nah.
Did he have bars?
No, he did not. Damn. At all. Did not have bars.
How soon into the song did you realize he did not have bars?
As soon as he turned the shit on. The beat drop that he was like, yo! I was like, nah. This is not it.
He wasn't bringing that baby shark heat?
No, he was not bringing that baby shark heat at all.
Oh, man.
I was like, dude, and I play this shit.
Everyone that got kids was like, I get that reference.
Yeah, I get it.
Or people like me, I was like, what the fuck is baby shark?
I had to Google baby shark. It's funny because I went home and I see baby shark on Twitter and I just like randomly started saying it in the crib.
Mm-hmm.
And then all my kids like activated like fucking Alexas in the crib. Like, they're all in different rooms, like, baby shark, do. I'm like, what the fuck, bro? Like, how do you know about? Oh, it's on YouTube. It's like, it's like 1 million hits on YouTube. I was like, what the fuck?
My neighbor's kid was singing in the elevator. And first of all, I was like, all right, it's 7. Like, you're starting your day. I'm ending mine. So like, I need you to bring that down a little.
Like, turn it down.
Because I'm leaning on the wall, like, yo, press 5 because all the buttons is moving. But
press 55. Like,
just hit all the buttons, like, fuck it, obviously it's home.
I'll just take the local, fuck it.
But the mother was just like, oh, that's all he sings at home is just baby shark over and over. And the way she said it, it was like birth control. I was like, oh, shit. Like, nah, stop. You like sleeping? I slept in a week. All I hear is baby shark.
Fucking baby shark. What the fuck? She's driving me crazy. Yo.
I thought baby shark was that other one about the father and the sugar. Wasn't that popular with babies?
Oh, yeah.
Is there a chart where, like, you can find, like, what songs babies are listening to?
The Baby Billboard 100? Yeah. Hot 100?
I'm Casey Kasem.
Welcome to the Baby Billboard Hot 100. At the number one, we have for the 20th week in the row, we have Yes, Papa.
Telling lies, no, Papa. I'm like, that sounds mad creepy, though.
All baby songs go creepy. But I guess because they're not written for adults, there's not really songwriting. There's no lead up. There's no character development. It's like, sing about color. Like, yo, I got a circle. The circle's blue. Kids are like, yo that's what I call motherfucking bars, nigga.
You know nothing about that.
Yo, the remix parallelogram.
Yo, shit.
That's that J. Cole shit. You're not ready for that.
Ready, chill. Yo, you got to overstand that,
yo,
brother.
That's for like fifth graders.
Come on, son. You're not ready? Nigga, come on. You ain't even on grade level.
Yo.
That's got, that Common Core shit, nigga.
You got the diss track D is for dog. Go.
Yo, up next we got this fire Spot Goes to School.
You got the seventh graders like, y'all don't listen to that old school. Well, give me that pop, hop on pop shit.
Yeah,
that's that real hip hop
shit.
Yeah,
that real 10 up, right? Tenables on top.
Yo,
shit.
Put on that Green Eggs and Ham.
Yeah.
That's that real shit.
Real shit, real hip hop, hip hop.
Does Dr. Seuss still release new shit?
I think he's dead.
You're supposed to know this shit.
I'm pretty sure he's dead.
You can still release. Then you got Ghost Riders.
I mean, Pac can do it. So
Rafi. Oh, Rafi. You got to put proper.
Rafi.
Well, yeah. He got new music coming out.
Oh, he does.
You know, he became an anti-war protester, and he's like a lives in Canada.
Well, shout out to him.
But he also made guap off the, what was this song, like Baby Beluga?
Oh yeah. Oh, ooh. Shit. I think it said Baby Beluga.
Baby Beluga was like fucking Mo Bamba back
yo,
in the day, man.
Yo, what? You heard that shit?
That like, shit will come on. Baby, I got Baby Belugas and a nigga's own. Just tearing up the daycare like, yo.
Nigga, Millie rocking
like
a motherfucker.
She's like, try to go to a nap. You're like, bitch, no. Start throwing blocks.
Yes, yes, y'all. And I'm eating baby eggs.
Baby Beluga.
Oof. Oh my God. Is caviar a real thing? Or did I just make that up because I want to sound rich?
I don't know, but I thank you that you feel comfortable enough asking me. Like, I wouldn't have to answer for that because I don't. I didn't even know like that's where caviar came from.
It's fish eggs.
I thought it was like Spam-a-lot or some shit.
Spam-a-lot?
I thought it came in like a can.
You thought it was a musical star, Clay Aiken?
The fact that you had that reference on deck, I have questions for the cameras not rolling. I know, I didn't realize there were different types of caviar. Are you out here? Are you ordering caviar on Seamless?
No, yo, I'm not going to hold you. I ordered sushi with caviar on it the other day. It was delicious. Well,
that's okay. That's, you know, that's kind of
like a, that's like a mid flex.
I thought you were getting like chopped cheese with caviar.
Yeah, like weird flex, but okay.
Caviar.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, there's mad, there's levels to this.
But
shit.
You have to have like special utensils to eat caviar and all this.
Yeah,
shit.
You gotta have like a mat, like a tiny spoon. You know what I'm saying? Just eat the fucking eggs. Like,
that's just a change because you know what we use the Chinese spoons for.
Yeah, the Adderall.
Gotta get started.
Yeah, give me a Diet Coke.
Damn, caviar is really out here like that, huh?
Yeah, caviar, Adderall, we out here. Just combine the two.
I don't, that shit, that's New Year's right there. I was about to say no, but that might be, that might be the new wave.
Adderall and caviar.
Rolling a blunt with it?
The Peanut Butter Boys mixtape dropping soon.
Adderall and caviar.
Adderall and caviar.
Do you have caviar at Applebee's?
I think so. Yeah, but it's
you
like,
clearly have not been to an Applebee's.
They nuke it.
They nuke it. When's last time you've been to Applebee's? I know you're living that rich life in Jersey now. What's the most popping slow food place
joint?
In Jersey?
Slow food place in Jersey.
Like it was like.
Well, I mean, like I'm a Bronx nigga, so like, I'm a trash bag. Like I just go to the food court. I just fuck Chick-fil-A up. Like everybody at Chick-fil-A knows who I am. Like damn. I go straight to Chick-fil-A. Like I go to the mall for anything, and mm-hmm. I go straight to Chick-fil-A first because I'm like I smoke an entire blunt in the parking lot. Under the cover, you know what I'm saying? And the indoor shit, not the outdoor shit, because it's a hot boy.
Okay.
Gets wild smack, walk through Neiman, you know what I'm saying? Just float that fake floss, like, oh shit, oh, little Givenchy, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Saying the French, you know what I mean? Then boom, hit the Lego store, you know what I'm saying? See what's popping over there. I lost my train of thought, it doesn't matter.
You go to Chick-fil-A.
And then I go to Chick-fil-A, boom.
So,
and I get extra. Because
Chick-fil-A is delicious.
Because it's fucking delicious.
It's so good that you would throw any allyship with the LGBT community under the bus.
Listen.
For fried chicken.
Listen.
Wow.
Listen.
Wow.
Listen. I support all my brothers and sisters in the struggle. You know what I'm saying? And also all my gender fluid people. But them nuggets be hitting, bro.
Wow.
That Polynesian sauce be fucking hitting, bro. And I don't even know if it's Polynesian. I think that's cultural appropriation.
I think it's
might be.
You
weren't
the last time
well.
You seen a Polynesian working the counter at Chick-fil-A. To be fair, I've only been to two Chick-fil-A's, but
the dude from Moana is fucking giving you chicken sandwich. I don't even know if that's the right. Damn, fuck, we wildin'. Problematic.
You know what? Chick-fil-A. Chick-fil-A, there's a lot of Chick-fil-A's in New York for everything New York stands for.
You know what I'm saying?
And Chick-fil-A came in and was like, nah, we just old Chick-fil-A and we not open on we Sunday. Why? That's Jesus Day, nigga.
It's Jesus Day, motherfucker. I'm like, yo, what if...
And we put up with it. That's the only place that's like, yo, we're not going to be open on a certain day. And we're like, all right. I just come on Monday. That's cool.
I'll be like, I just go on Saturday, bro. I'll just send a goy.
If Chick-fil-A wasn't as polite as they... Did you say a goy?
I'll just send a goy to get my Chick-fil-A on Saturday. Shout out to my Jew gang. Say we out here banging. Judaism gang, we out here.
All right. I can't even... See, you're over here saying Drake's culturally appropriate. Look at you. You've been like four different nationalities so far on this podcast, Mero. You got regal in one hand. You got some homin touches over here. Pick a side.
Yo, this brisket is hitting.
Is Hanukkah over? Was your Hanukkah popping?
My Hanukkah was kind of lit. I got some cologne and shit and some PlayStation games.
That don't sound fun.
I wanted a chain, but
you have a chain.
I wanted another.
You can't
chain.
Even give a chains on Hanukkah. I don't know anything about that. I've never seen any of my Jewish friends just come out with a wild, brolic link chain after Hanukkah.
With the Jesus
piece. Yes, like, with the Jesus piece.
Yo, juice for Jesus, juice for Jesus. Juice for Jesus, we out here.
Like, people are like, yo, excuse, we can't do the Seder prayer because your chain's banging the
yo,
table.
I'm sorry.
You got it in the plate for Elijah.
Oh, sorry. Somebody get my chain out of the green bean casserole, please.
You got it in the lockers.
It's stuck.
You said a chain. a chain with your face on it or like a dreidel?
Yeah.
Or, wow. No one's ever done like a spinning dreidel. Like, remember how.
A dreidel chain?
A dreidel chain that just keeps spinning and it's iced out.
And it got like chocolate in it. Oh, it's okay, lit. It got gelt. Yeah.
Oh.
Real gelt in it. Like, you open it up and it's like, whoop.
I've heard that word before, so yeah. Yes. Gelt.
Yeah. I got mad gelt on deck at the crib.
That's just chocolate, right?
It's just chocolate coins. Yeah, that's it.
I'm almost on to you people. All right. Y'all running a scam.
We're running scams. They just want to get days off from school.
So wait,
shit.
You give candy out and this holiday is not too far away from Halloween?
Yeah. So it's like, yo.
You just pass it in the gelt down?
Your gelt is in the shape of a Snickers mini now. Fam, here. These are leftovers. Yeah. Take that and enjoy it, stupid.
How much gelt do you give? Like,
you know what I'm saying? I got a little donut, so, you know, I'm just out here at Dollar Tree just copping all the gelt.
Oh, does it have to be like those gold coins?
Yeah. In a little mesh bag.
Wow, you learned so much.
You know what I'm saying?
Why a mesh bag? Why?
I don't know. They just come in mesh bags. I don't know. That somebody monopolized gelt, mm-hmm. and there's one company that makes all of it, and it all comes in mesh bags.
Big gelt?
Yeah, big gelt.
Damn.
We got to investigate big gelt. That's what we're going to do on our Showtime show, investigate big gelt. You know what I'm saying? See how they're Philip Morris? The Philip Morris of gelt.
How they're brainwashing kids into getting gelt at school? Gelt. All right. You learn something new every day on
you
this
know
podcast.
What I'm out here, bro.
I think you just learned something new as well. So
I'm in the seasonal aisle just copping mad candles and gelt and shit. Like, yo.
What's the best part of Hanukkah?
The disappointment on my kids' face when they open books after the first day of Hanukkah.
Damn.
Because the first day is like, yo, Nintendo Switch. Second day is like, here's a book, nigga, about Hanukkah.
Well, I mean, they shot too far with it. Like, it's what is it, 12 days?
8 days.
8 days.
8 days. That's a lot. That's a lot of gifts.
I think of it like this. Like, when people visit your house, is there anyone you know that you would let chill in your house for 8 days? You're going to get sick of them? Like, you wake up like, God damn, it's still Hanukkah?
You still here, mom?
Damn. Here, take these socks.
Yo, I'll buy you tickets to DR. Here, please.
See, like, Kwanzaa, we made the same mistake. How many days are there in Kwanzaa, people? Very quiet in here. Very quiet
like,
in here.
Heaven's like,
I guess we're going to have to do a Kwanzaa special at Showtime.
Heaven says 7 or 8. Like it's a showcase showdown.
Turn his face. It's like 12 and a possible. But you know what? There's no Kwanzaa guide. All we just need is one song. You know what? If we learn the Cupid Shuffle from the Cupid Shuffle
yes.
song, if we make a Kwanzaa song with instructions, yes. like two hops this time,
yes.
we can make Kwanzaa a thing.
I was going to say Kwanzaa great again. But
no, we're not making Kwanzaa. We're not wearing red MAK hats. Make Kwanzaa great again? Macca.
McGaga.
Yeah. And damn, if we had done some Kwanzaa licensing with Black Panther.
You know what I'm saying?
We missed out.
We would have fucked that shit up.
That shit up.
Woo! Damn, they
have like a Kwanzaa bush, wow, I guess.
Black Panther Rockefeller Kwanzaa candles. Damn, bro.
I'm sure they have them, but like a Crenshaw swap meet and shit. Yeah, like this ain't authorized.
Yeah, nah. Not somebody putting stickers, printing out stickers mm-hmm. and putting them on candles.
It's like Black Panther, y'all. Like, no, there's no y'all in it. Like, there's no y'all. Now you turn into Black Exploitation. So I'm the Black Panther. Got the wild afro. Like,
what up, B? Somebody just scrubbed out the Mac.
Wakanda's just a boulevard in Spanish Harlem.
Kwanzaa needs to rebrand, B. Just like Scientology, B. Like and Jehovah's Witness.
Those are three different things. Yeah. Those are three very different things.
I don't even know what Scientology. Yo, honestly, yo.
You don't have to. We're popping. We will be Scientology in like a year.
In a year?
We're super gullible.
What's
we'll
the over-under? What's the over-under on us being Scientologists?
I feel you could be in Scientology before I can. Like, I'm probably just going to, like, meet some Hollywood chick and she's going to force me into it or some shit. Just,
like, she's like, yo, fuck Kabbalah. This shit is like,
nah, she got me wearing some red string. I don't know. I'm donating 8% of my profits. But, if you kids were Scientologists, it'd be cute.
I just have the little meter attached to them and shit. Like, yo, we got to get rid of this one.
The Zeta levels are down.
The vibes aren't good.
No, Syracuse was cute when she was, like, not talking and shit.
Syracuse.
Cruz. Not cute. All right, I left out a letter.
Syracuse. I was like,
I'm like, why people? You guys don't know this girl's name? You think about Mello? Like, oh shit, it's 2 for 3.
Yeah. I'm like, yo, nobody wants to go to Syracuse.
Suri Cruz.
Shout out to her. What is she doing now? Is she like at Whole Foods?
I guess getting
like,
deprogrammed and shit.
She's on her charging dock. Like. Yo. Tom Cruise is all of 4 feet tall.
Well, we all know that.
Yeah.
But we accept it.
You know what I'm saying? That's for the younger crowd that didn't know.
But see, once you realize it, now his movies, they're just like ridiculous. Yeah. You know, he's like on an Apple box with 10 takes.
Yeah, he's on Top Gun, like sitting on a phone book and shit. Like, yo.
What's that one he was in? It was like, it was not John Wick. It was another one, and it had like the wild fake porno name.
Fuck.
Jack Reacher. Yeah. That's definitely the name of a person checking into a hotel to cheat on their wife. Like,
So
Mr. Jack Reacher.
I'm
here.
Jack Reacher. Yeah.
But then you're watching it, he's fucking people up. And I'm like, wow. Wait a minute. And you start noticing the camera angles are weird. I was like, where's his ankles?
How come you never see his feet?
Is he on a booster seat in that car?
He got the Bootsy Collins fucking shoes on and shit. Like,
I wanna fuck you.
Tom Jack Cruise. Reacher. That's such a Pino name too. That like, is. Yo. Like, fam.
Jack Reacher.
Jack
the
Reacher.
Doctor will see you now.
Bow, bow, bow.
Jack Reacher and Jaden James and Naughty Nurses 5.
I'm mad I was going to correct you and tell you what number of Naughty Nurses is up to, but you know what? It's actually 57. Give them their work.
Yo, porns have the longest running franchises in like.
It's called
history.
Naughty Nurses. There's no backstory. it's a girl in a nursing hat. We're not following her through medical school. There's no.
She's like Monroe and scrubs.
There's no
and
scene
shit,
of
like,
just her like God frustrated studying for the finals. Like, ah.
Oh. No.
Well, there might be. And then, like, to get the wild massage. Like, oh, you're so tense.
Oh,
it's
yo.
Like,
oh, yo, is this phlebotomy? Yo, it's killing me. Yo, it's OD.
Oh, God. Pino. That nursing, what is that like the definitive occupation? That and babysitters. And porno. And teachers.
Oh, yeah. And for,
you never see like tax attorney?
Yeah, never.
Never no. A paralegal?
No. Taking it beyond tax attorney, you never seen a Pino where somebody has got the Statue of Liberty shit on and they're spinning the sign in front of the tax place? Like, come get your taxes done here? You know what I'm saying? That has never been made into a Pinot, and
not
it should
yet.
Be. Yeah,
that would be kind of hot.
You know what I'm saying? To keep the crown on and shit, like
still wearing the Statue of Liberty outfit.
Yeah,
and shit. Like,
oh, yo,
give me 100 masses. Like, oh shit,
spitting the sign while you smashing.
Someone at Liberty Tax Services is like brilliant.
Brilliant. Let's use it.
So at the Liberty Tax Services, if you people feel safe getting your taxes done at a place that is also a dry cleaner half the year,
Yeah, if they put on an awning for 2 months out of the year, like, good luck, fam.
Like, as soon as it turns midnight on April 15th, they're like, yo, we out.
Now you can get a dollar sign.
They leave mad receipts and shit on there. Like, yo, if the IRS call you, that's your ass. Like, they be asking you questions that they should know as a taxer. Yo, they're like, yo, is that legal?
Yo, what's a 1099?
That's wild.
Do you gotta bring? Do you give that to somebody else? Or
you know
bring
what?
It to me?
I think you mean why your social security number got so many digits? Should only be like 5, right?
Is all right. Yeah, right. It's like a zip.
They just be entering shit in the computer. And talking, as soon as the shit turned green, they're like, "All right, next." Yo, you got a tractor? I was like, "No, I live in the Bronx. They're like, we're going to put you down for a taxi.
Don't tell nobody.
Farm subsidies.
I got you.
Sometimes you get nervous. You be like, yo, chill. Like, relax. I know I'm going to get audited on that shit. Like, chill.
Chill, you good.
Chill, we just going to say you sublet the Port Authority.
Yeah. You run a child daycare center. You got, man, how many nonprofits do you want?
You know what? We make it 10.
I bet.
I'm like, yo, you realize we both going to jail, right? I'm just taking my chances.
He's like, fuck it, I'm rolling the dice, man. I got one shot a year, my G.
Sometimes you look around that waiter room, be like, this is not a safe place to file my taxes. These niggas are going to steal my identity. But then by that time, your credit is so fucked, you don't care if people steal your identity. Yeah. Like, it's not worth the trouble.
I'm like, yo, fam, if you steal my credit, you're welcome. Thank you.
I call Equifax so they can laugh at you. Like, boy.
Damn, how is this?
Hold on.
Is there supposed to be another digit in your credit score?
Shireen, come here. Come look at this.
This nigga credit score 86.
What?
What the fuck? I've never seen some shit like this.
Is that shit just an emoji?
it's the crying laughing emoji.
I like, what's taking so long? They're like, with this credit score, you out in no rush, boy. I'm like, oh, damn.
Oh, shit.
I'm trying to rebuild my shit. What's a good credit score?
I think 700s, right?
Is that?
Yeah.
700s?
I keep looking at her like, yo, she knows everything. I've been doing how many days of Kwanzaa? How many? What's taxes? So she's like, yo, 8 days, do your taxes. I'm like, yo, shit.
Oh, man.
Victor got some stiff competition as the fat god. What's the last day you can do your taxes?
No, you can do your taxes any day you want.
If you're not with the Snipes.
If you're talking about when the IRS wants your taxes, that's a whole different calendar. Because the thing about the IRS, like, they're like, yo, even if you can't pay, you got to let us know, and we'll work on a payment plan. But you're also like, fuck you.
Fuck yeah.
I don't got the money. Also, as you all know, I'm a sovereign citizen like Wesley Snipes. I do not respect the U.S. government. I follow nautical rules, and I do not pay taxes. I'm going to regret saying that.
Every tax season, you're just in a rowboat in international waters.
I just go, I can't touch me.
You mad.
My CPA's a dolphin.
You tight.
All my receipts get wet in seawater. I'm like, I was at the Ritz. It's like, kale on it.
A dolphin with a green visor pop up the water like, you get audited.
Flipper. Come on. It's like, that happen.
With the big ass calculator with the fucking roll of paper on it.
Yo, Wesley Snipes was really not paying taxes?
He didn't give a fuck.
Damn.
Nigga, you did Blade, bro.
Yeah.
That shit did numbers. Pay taxes, bro.
Anytime you let a black man run around with a leather jacket with a sword.
Come on, man.
He's going to get gas.
Went to his head, bro.
I was like, yo, chill, Wesley.
Yo, Uncle Sam is a bloodsucker.
And they was on him since New Jack City. So.
Yeah.
Damn. Is that why we never, what did we get? We got Blade 2 and we never got Blade 3, right?
I think.
Blade Trinity.
That's not canon.
That's not in the Criterion collection.
All right. As I go back to alt.film.blade on my Google, my Yahoo Google group. I'm the only person that's still checking in. I'm like, guys, I really need you to respond to the emails when I send them out.
Come on, guys. If you're inactive for more than 2 months, we're going to remove you from the group.
By the way, I can't seem to log into our Flickr, so I don't know.
She just got a scrolling fucking text on the bottom. Straight GeoCities flow.
God.
Shout out to all the Angel Fire fan pages out there.
Oh, those old... That's what I said it on Twitter yesterday. That's what Kanye was doing. He's trying to bring back LiveJournal. Think about it. Anytime you was like tweeted about someone that did it was mean to you. This person doesn't like me. They're bullying me.
What was this shit that was like LiveJournal but it had like kind of like an anime-ish name?
Hey!
Z-Way with the save! With the alley-oop! God damn! We out here! Whole gang in here!
Oof. What's the new... Damn, did Twitter and Facebook, they just ruin, like, so there's no, like, niche...
That's it.
I mean, shout out to our aunties that are still on Black Planet. Yeah. You know, it's still happening.
Yeah, shout out to Black Planet. Shout
still leaving that dripping cherry, you know, animated gift.
Yeah, boy.
Y'all are both too old to be flirting, but you know what? Y'all going to do it anyway.
Hey, you're talking about bracket, source, putting a link to a song in there, dot wave.
Just some maintenance worker like, damn, girl, you look good. I was like, that's my aunt. She has diabetes.
Stop.
Okay? Don't be leaving pages like that on her.
Why you think all her pictures are from the waist up?
He's like, yo, I like your pressure thighs. Like, no, chill. Those are socks that help her circulation.
Fam,
what's wrong with you?
That's not, her right foot is not real, but you don't touch
it. She back on his page like, I like your sleep apnea machine.
Yo, hit my G-book, man.
Catch me sexy newbie in 402 at yahoo.com.
Like alternating caps.
I'm like, how long you had this email address?
You put that shit on a resume?
You just got just the one. sexyberry49 at yahoo.com. They're like, ma'am, this is a job interview.
Well, I'm a sexy berry, motherfucker.
I'm applying for both jobs. Got that.
Shout out to all the titties. I got the two eyes tattooed on the back.
That was a hot tattoo for a while.
For a minute, yeah. That was like up there with the dripping cherries.
Yeah. But I mean, what was the point of that? Like, so you had eyes looking at you and you was like hitting it from the back?
But yeah, I guess. So you can make eye contact while you smashing? that's weird.
That's kind of concerning. What mean, if the tattoo artist
is
though,
not good though? Like,
and it's not even?
And it's like kind of like cockeyed a little bit, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I guess you would use a ruler.
Just put it on the back.
Like a triple bail balance or some shit. That's like considerate though. They got like they're giving you like it's like someone who leaves a magazine in the bathroom for you.
That's
it's
true.
Like reading material while
you're
back there.
Yeah, go do your thing.
You ever see someone that have like a poem or like a verse on their back?
Yo, I'm gonna keep it real. Like I need to read when I take a shit. So, like I'll read anything.
I have no idea where you're going with this, but
like I'll read. Like I literally read anything. Like I have to read. I have to grab something and read it while I take a shit. Like my bowels won't like release unless I'm reading. True story. So like
wait,
I'm saying,
how?
I don't know.
I don't think that's how it works.
I don't know. I know it's not probably.
So you mean to tell me, like,
I mean,
if you,
to be fair,
if you had to go, you just like, yo, I need a book.
Yeah, I need something. A tube of toothpaste. I'll read the ingredients. You know what I'm saying? Approved by the ADA. You know, no fluoride. You know what I'm saying? All that.
Wow.
I'm reading the back of like a Lever 2000 bar and shit. Like, oh, no parabens. All right, that's lit. What are parabens? What are parabens? Why? What are parabens? And why is everybody so scared of parabens?
I don't know. This is my first time ever hearing this word.
You know what I'm saying? Also, BPA. Like, shit is BPA free.
BPA,
like,
I know that. That's a police benevolent association. You do not want the problems with that.
I got a BPA card.
You got a BPA card? You get pulled over. Hey, my brother's on the force.
I just showed them my Nalgene bottle. Like, yo, it's BPA. That means I get to go free.
Oh, you got a fucking wise guy over here.
Get in the car, asshole.
Oh.
Yo.
BPA. What do you say? Paraffins or?
Parabens.
Parabens?
Yeah, I don't know. What are they? Are they like tiny? Like
they're like magnets. Who knows? We'll never know.
Yeah. How do they work?
We're the juggalos of parabens.
Parabens? Fucking
also,
parabens.
Shout out to you. I don't know if this is a flex. You said you got Lever 2000?
That is not a flex. No, Lever 2000 is straight jail soap.
Fam, I buy soap one bar at a time at the Bodega.
I go to BJ's. If you go to BJ's and a 20-pack of soap is $6,
see,
that's probably not the best soap.
See, I know that, but here's the thing. I'm not paying for a BJ's membership to go. I live by myself. Well, I look with 50 bars of soap. Because then what happens, you think you're saving money, but it's just reminding you that you're going to probably die alone. You know how sad I get every time I look into my sink? I got like 28 rolls of toilet paper. I'm like, I'm never going to finish this
myself. I'm never going to shit this much.
Just open my fridge. It's like a fucking 3-liter bottle of ketchup mocking me. You're not going to eat this many hot dogs.
Ah!
This is for people with families.
Ah!
I'm like, ah.
It's just
on a fucking 3-pound bag of sugar. Like,
They're all doing an intervention. They're like, you keep buying in bulk.
I'm saving. It's savings.
No, you're not. You're destroying yourself. You're destroying your life. You're destroying your life. We care about you.
Shout out to also, BJ's got the wild, strict policy about your face has to match the name on the card.
I just woke in that bitch like with no card.
Well, no one's trying to stop you. I'm pretty sure like you got the BJ's in New Jersey under pressure. Like people changing their shift. Like, I don't want to deal with him.
I woke in there like Debo, like, yo, what up? Yo, I need 16 pounds of salami pre-sliced.
Oh, shit. It's Mero. Hide the oat milk. Hide the oat milk. Like, take all the samples. Like, ah.
Yo, give me that shit. I just take the whole tray and dump it in my mouth. Make more now.
Let's go to BJ's, pick up some tires, a shotgun, and a standing piano.
You know what I'm saying? Homie got the little fucking microphone. He's like, this knife cuts anything. I'm like, yo, let me see that fucking chocolate you got behind you right there. Let me see that.
BJ's.
He's like, well, you get one with the purchase of a knife. I was like, no, give me the fucking chocolate, motherfucker.
See the difference? And they still got the Red Bull locked up in my supermarket. Just hurts my heart every time I walk in.
They lock
in
up the Red Bull?
Red Bull, Infamil, and
why Red Bull?
Shrimp.
Oh, because it's
that's stuff people shoplift.
Oh, because they out here drinking rum and Red Bull.
All right. First of all, that song is for my culture. So a little more respect. That's actually our national anthem.
Yo, shout out to Jamaicans, because Jamaicans will make a song about anything they like and the shit will be fire.
What's the problem with that?
Like,
why the rest of y'all get like that?
Like, yo, okay? Like, motherfuckers made a whole song.
We don't
about
have
Clarks.
Much, but what we have is rhythm.
Yo, Clarks, me prefer. Clarks for the summer, Clarks for the winter.
Our short foot pants.
Toothbrush, get out the dust.
Americans
fast.
Need to be like that. Make one about your president doing Adderall.
You know what I'm saying?
Partner sniff. Partner sniff.
Yeah, I like to sniff. Yeah, check it. Boom.
That's it.
Who gets his Adderall from, though?
From probably,
you think Pence is getting it? Pence
nah,
is connect?
Nah, Pence off them Zans, bro. You've seen him. He was like,
I took half of Zans.
Yo, it was leaning, bro.
It was out.
It was like, yo, fam, don't die. Like, did you just perish on air? Yo, your man was like, he was at astronomy lecture hall and shit, like for 4 hours.
He was like, nodding.
Yo.
About to hit him with the Narcan. Like, yo, you all right?
I'm good.
You all right, Pets? Pets.
Yo.
Master your high. Master your high.
I'll break open the smelling salts from the French state kid. Like, he's up there like, mother, where are you? Mother.
I was thinking about horse sticks again.
Oh, man. Mike Pence, aka Mr. Hands.
See, I'm glad no one got that reference, so we're just going to keep it moving. Wow. Yo. Mr. Hands.
Mr. Hands.
That name again is Mr. Hands.
Mr. Hands, bro. See what happens?
You guys all know who Mr. Hands is, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, everybody knows?
You know?
You familiar with Mr. Hands? Sherry's like, I don't even want to know.
She's no. Let's leave Sherry nice and innocent. She doesn't need to know these things. Google Mr. Hands when you get home, but not from a work computer.
Yeah, please. Do not Google Mr. Hands from your work
computer. Because that's definitely going to put you on a Google list.
Yo, for real.
And let me tell you, the sponsored ads you're going to see are going to be very dramatically different. You're like, what the fuck, a riding crop?
Whoa.
What about this?
How did I go from tech fleeces to horsey tail butt plugs? Like, what happened? God damn.
Like, what?
No kink shaming, though.
Shout no kink everybody shaming. Who enjoys horsey
well,
tail
nah,
butt plugs.
Some kinks you gotta be like right.
Chill.
Like it's what's not shaming, but it's like, all right, you're doing a lot.
Doing a lot? Is it like that hanging, that shit that people do, like when they hang hooks in their body and they like hang like sexually?
But is that sexual? Or is that just like
know.
You just chilling?
Like you never know.
I don't even know. I might have to do that. My back locks up sometimes. Like
you just gonna stick meat hooks in your back.
I'm not gonna get one of those inverted things with a corny.
Just stop walking in your crib, you upside down.
I'm like, just leading, man. Like, you're gonna see mad blood dripping in here. I'm just like, ah! just my lower vert, you know, I took the red on my back's tight. Ah!
My L5.
Matter of fact, put another hook in my back. If you getting like earthworms, if you like women stomping on earthworms and shit, I'm a kind of judge.
Yeah, that's, yeah, I'm gonna keep
like, if you went to some shit that you can't just casually have on like a big screen while I'm at your apartment without me being like, yo, fam, like, you're making me uncomfortable.
Fam, they're eating shit.
Yeah. Well, okay, you went there.
They're eating shit. How do you
see, the problem isn't the eating shit.
I just grab a tube of toothpaste and shit and watch the shit like
the problem isn't so much the eating shit, but it's like, is it like a 20-minute scene?
Yeah.
You gotta have like a little shit eating. It's gonna happen.
It's a little shit eating.
But if it's like a 20-minute scene, like after 5 minutes, you're like, how much shit?
What did y'all eat?
Like, yeah. Like now just cause like y'all not getting enough roughage?
Like, what the fuck, bro? This shit is coming out like soft serve.
I'm like making a NutriBullet. I'm like, I don't want this now.
Come on. Oh, you had kale.
Nasty. Does our generation, this new generation, they don't have a two girls, one cup?
They don't.
But they, I think they've been so desensitized to everything.
Showtime promo.
No.
Two dudes, one cup. We out here. Let's get it.
I mean, whatever for the ratings, right?
You gotta get security bag.
We find out after the film, like, yo, oh, they used ice cream?
Oh, shit.
Well, I wish I knew that going into this.
God damn, huh? I was nervous.
You don't want to be in the trailer after that shoot.
I knew it was a hoax because Mero wasn't reading.
The makeup lady just comes and blots my face and gives me gum. I'm like, nah. Nah.
It's a little anti-shine.
They're like, pickups. I'm like, ah.
Okay, all right.
Where was my tongue? All right.
Jeez. You see the Matt Talenti gelato and shit? Like,
no one wants to be near me for the walkaway lunch.
Yo, point that fan over here, yo. This motherfucker's tearing this shit up.
Two girls, one cup. There's no two guys, one cup, right?
No.
There gotta be. We don't know scat porn like that.
That's true. Yeah. There's definitely a video up there.
Like if there was a Jeopardy category and it was scat porn, I'm not picking 200.
Nah.
I'm not picking 1,000 either.
Daily double. Daily like, dump.
Damn.
Daily dump.
They'd be like, her groundbreaking scene was the first time a woman ever appeared on film. I'm like, what? They'd be like, you don't know that?
You know,
it's a journey of truth.
Yeah, she took a dump. Fucking
she took a dump for freedom.
For freedom? Oh my God.
She's a groundbreaker. Is that the problematic line? This is every now and then. I mean, we were talking about scat for like 10 minutes.
Yeah, that's true. That's absolutely
like that,
true.
That can't be the line where you...
Yeah, I'm serious.
Listen, this isn't Pod Save America. You're not going to get politics on this.
You're going to get scat talk.
Scat talk.
Scatology.
Scat talk.
We're the scat guys.
We just got on the big zoot suits.
Yo. Damn. Now, yeah, see, now I'm going to go home and like look up scat porn on my computer.
Why?
Just because we talked about it. And I'm curious. I've never, aside from Two Girls, One Cup, I've never seen like shit porn.
I think it's illegal.
Is it?
I want to say, yeah.
In the United States? Can I use like a proxy?
Listen, again, there has to be some sort of clause in that Showtime deal. Think of it. He was arrested for some nasty shit.
I didn't even read the shit. I just signed the contract. It was like yo, you cannot watch scat porn.
He was like, I definitely would be like, hold up.
Or make any reference to
Mr. Hands. Called the lawyer like, get that scat clause thing out of there.
Yeah.
Just cross it out. Like,
we're not signing until we get the scat clause removed.
Oh, scat clause. Yeah. No, I'm pretty sure it's illegal in the United... Wait, yeah. I
know fucking animals is illegal.
Who's going to go and legislate for scat porn?
Who's gonna be the hero?
Who's lobbying for that? who's going up to Capitol Hill like, we demand this?
We demand shit on our chest.
Mr. Trump, what are you going to do about the Scott Ukraine racials?
Well, I mean, usually I pee on people, but if you want to do dookie on somebody, that's your prerogative. Thank you.
Wait, if he peed on people...
You know he dookied on somebody.
Just wild Adderall
up?
Like,
you know he did. Yeah. You know he had the coke shits. You know
mad
what I'm saying?
Mad focus, too?
Yeah. Hey, he was around the 80s, so you know he was doing wild yay.
Yeah, with some prelude shits,
that well, that wapude. My man's butthole was dilated at all times.
Because he was getting skied up with Mike Tyson, allegedly.
Allegedly.
So,
even though there's a wild picture of Mike Tyson with wild coke on his nose.
I just said that allegedly because I don't want Mike Tyson to fuck me up.
Oh, yeah.
Mike Tyson in 2018 is still terrifying.
Yeah, seriously. Because that's what they asked on Twitter. Like, yo, would you take 10 Mike Tysons versus one gorilla? That was like the Twitter question of the day. And I was just like, yo, I was like, is Mike Tyson on coke?
Well, I mean, any.
Because then I seen two gorillas fighting at a zoo. And I was just like, yo, the motherfuckers.
Gorillas will fuck you up.
They will fuck you up.
Gorillas
will.
And also, you have to imagine a gorilla would be extra upset that a human tried to fight it.
Like, yo, for real, fam?
Like, a gorilla probably see all these tweets. Like, other gorillas are sending gorillas these tweets. Like, yo, you see this shit?
You see this shit?
Yo, they really think they can flex on us.
Oh, you think I'm pussy?
Oh.
I bet.
I'm pussy?
Bet.
Niggas shit this chest and shit.
Bet. All right. Yo, come cross that moat, nigga.
Gorillas look at us the way we looked at Tekashi 6ix9ine. They gonna make an example out of us, boy.
whole crew full of gorillas. I'm a gorilla, too.
Oh. Also, if you get beat by first of all, a gorilla's not going to beat you. It's going to kill you.
It's going to destroy you.
Because it's not going to stop halfway. Like, no. Yo, you can't be like, yo, time out. And the gorilla's like, ook.
He's like, yo, you good?
You good?
The gorilla's not going to stop. Like, yo, you good? You all right?
You all right? All right, I'm going to chill. I was waxing you.
Yo.
Imagine a gorilla beat you, and then like, afterwards, he's not even like breathing heavy. He opens a banana, just eating it.
He's the shit. Picks up his dookie, throws it at somebody looking in the enclosure.
Get mad potassium and shit.
They can just roll you into the dry moat. Like, get the fuck out of here, you
heard. What's definitely a zoo animal you could fuck up?
Probably the seals at the Bronx Zoo.
Nah.
I just stand on the rock.
They're slippery. They got that big tail. Once they get you in the water, now you're in the water.
If you get in the water, then you assed out.
Well, where else are you going to fight a seal at?
They got like the rock that they come and sunbathe on. I just post up on the rock like with the box cutter ready. When feeding time comes and she throws the little minnows in the air, you know what I'm saying? I just be like, whop.
I think a sea lion will fuck you up.
I don't know. It depends on their jaw strength. Did you know that hyenas attack... other animals by their genitals first?
Yeah.
Because that's the weak spot.
We covered that on our show.
Yeah. We did.
Yeah.
No, llamas do that.
Llamas?
And hyenas. That, yeah. Different mammals.
Damn, what was the name of that guy that got killed by the stingray? Steve Irwin. Ever since he died, like, the level of people giving facts about animals has dropped.
Like, dramatically.
It's just not.
It's sad, mate.
Somewhere his daughter's like, that's not it. That's not it at all.
That's not it, chief.
That's not it. While she's, like, fighting a kangaroo. Like,
yo, that brolic kangaroo died.
Yeah, shout out to Roger. What's his name, Roger?
Yeah, Roger.
Yeah.
R.I.P. Roger, damn. Yo. You up there with Harambe now, B.
That's sad.
You know what I'm saying?
He died at 12. How long do...
Kangaroos live?
Die. I mean, how long do they usually live? Heaven.
I was about to.
Wait, is that like? Hold on, we gotta know.
Is that old for a kangaroo? I mean, he was clearly juicing.
Kangaroo's life span. You know what? Google could just lie. Google would be like 40 years. You got to take it.
Yeah.
Oh, 12 years in the wild, 20 years in capacity. Captivity, excuse me.
12 years in the wild?
12 years in the wild.
And 20? Shit,
but 20, that's
zoo.
Like he's locked up and depressed and shit. Like,
yeah, he's just...
He's just like walking around them like mad sad and shit.
Just hands in a pouch and shit like...
Just sighing every now and then like his girl left him. Like, niggas caught me.
Damn, B.
That's all zoo animal thing. They're just sitting there like, damn, niggas caught
they
me.
They got me, B.
Fuck.
They got me in PC, yo, fuck like this. I'm a herb.
Trying to get out there to the penguin house. That's where the real G's be at. Where's protective custody in the zoo?
In the Bronx zoo, it's probably like the House of Darkness with like a little shrews and shit like that.
Yeah, those be snitches, right?
Yeah.
Damn.
Because you got to pay extra to get in there. So like if you're trying to go in there and kill a snitch, a shrew that snitched on you, you got to pay extra to get in there.
You're doing an episode of Zootopia that is very dark. Like, I'm not letting my kids watch this shit. This is like Law and Order Zoo Edition. Like... Killing snitching shrews.
Killing snitching shrews.
That sounds like new Baby Shark.
Baby shrew snitching. Stabbing up. Doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. Yeah. When we did that interview in the Bronx, were we just roasting all the animals?
Yeah, because
the
animals are stupid.
That was fun.
Those animals aren't even from the Bronx. They got caught and now they're in the Bronx Zoo.
Yo, you tight.
You should have. You feel tight.
You mad, bro.
You running around Zimbabwe. Bang, now look at you. You on Ishima.
Ah, you mad.
You didn't even talk the gang codes. You mad, lost. You mad. Birds come over here in the window, don't got no Tims on. Get disrespected at the bodega and shit.
Like, yo, you're not from here, motherfucker.
Get out of here.
Get in the back of the line, B.
Yo, this hippopotamus Tim's is fake.
Boy, just frozen each other.
It's been episode 138.
That's right, you cowards.
138th episode. I told you guys it gets hot in here, right? Right?
Yeah. Feels a little heat. Y'all sweating? Yeah. Y'all sweating?
Also, it doesn't help that we have the red light on here, so y'all are cooking like Pop-Tarts. it's been your boy, Jesus Nice, a.k.a.
Right.
Chipotle, a.k.a. Pocket Say Fat Like Tyrion, which we will change up for national reasons so we can be on Nickelodeon with Pocket Say Fat Like.
Here we go!
Chris Aspel Slingdick, Eli Lippy, Butchus Billy Gully, Slipping That Might Know You Bitch, Young Day Party,
oh
Young Hot
God.
Take, DJ Fuego, Mr. Nando's with a Rondo, Mil Novas at the Vente, Quattro, and Nova York, the Bill Coding Off, the Juve Boss, MC Goofy, putting up for 40 with your shorty. Listen, man, don't talk to me in the Uber pool.
I don't fucking know you, man.
I'm not here for conversation, dog.
Not at all, B.
You know what I'm saying? I'm tired.
I would have got an Uber XL, but...
My car was acting up. I'm
you know
like, I'm going to take an Uber pool from Brooklyn now.
Get out of here, B.
Shit is sad. There's a baby seat in here.
Yo, shout out to my Uber driver who literally had a baby in the front seat of his car when he drove me to work the other day.
Was it his baby?
It was. I mean,
or was it like a paying passenger?
I hope so.
I saw something on Channel 7 about people just be wanting their kids in Ubers and sending them places. You don't do that?
I mean, I might now. Shit, that's a great idea.
I mean, you don't gotta ride with them to school.
Like. Yo, Jersey, it's very easy to pass the driving test. It's a closed course. They don't put you, like New York, they put you out there.
Yeah, what's up with Jersey? Like, you guys don't pump your own gas. You don't know how to drive for shit.
Yeah, like, that's why Jersey drivers are so terrible, because they just put you in, like, a parking lot and are like, yo, can you turn the car on and make a circle? All right, cool, here's your license. That's it.
Full circle.
That's it.
The original my plus one got a plus one,
right.
So don't make a first sign. Jesus Rossi and Jamaican Jew, happy Hanukkah.
That's right.
Is that what's the proper Hanukkah greeting? Is just happy Hanukkah? It's not like some like
There's like there's a Hebrew one, but I'm not gonna fuck it up.
Well, come on. Give me a sample. Give us a taste.
I'll let you
give us it. give us a sample. Come on, give us a sample of Jew shit. Hasamea.
We gotta right? Smeach.
Is that like in the beginning of the Lion King?
Yeah. I know the candle song is Barakato. I don't know.
There's a candle song?
I'm paraphrasing.
I think that might be the candle song for like Yankee candles. That's not for Hanukkah.
I'd be like half singing the words and shit, like everybody else is singing. I'm just like, I just
come and take the Torah away from you. Like, yeah, this ain't it, Chief.
I just do the ad libs and shit. Like, word. Shout out to Aunt Wendy.
Juice it. 8 days.
Yo, Uncle Dave, big up, man. Uncle Dave.
Nebuchadnezzar, let's go.
PC Richard, give me the discount.
Yo, two. Phone Jones, DJ Machina, Jay Chuckle, Stanley Cups, the human Dr. Brown, Labor, like Duke, Deonato the Trapio, Mr. 240p, because I like my Pinot Blurry.
That's right.
DJ Warlike, AKA the Watch FM. Here's a song near and dear to every Yankee fan.
Let's go.
You should know this. I'm going to play, I don't know if they can hear it out loud, but I mean, this is a bit of a banger. Are you familiar with the redneck? But I've been forgotten.
Oh, shit!
I've been married a long time ago.
Wait, you guys remember a song called Cotton Eye Joe? You know they're not from America?
They're Swedish.
They're Swedish.
Swedish rednecks with an X.
There's no reason for this song to exist. There's no reason for them to play this at Yankee games.
That's Swedish people making fun of Americans.
That's what they think we look like. They think we all live in trailer parks.
No, I'm not. No, I've been fucking my sister. Go.
To be fair, a lot of Yankee fans do look like Cotton Eye Joe. I mean, it will love. The Curry Goes, DJ Spice, Jamal Haspel, the Bronx, Celine Dion, Ray and Nephews, Nephew DeMarino, Black Tano, the Human Mammy, Word to Ja, Young Aaron, Racist Provocateur, Henrik Buckles, Nelson Mandela, Sergio Can't See Me, Vladimir Buffet, the Human Word is melting in your mouth.
Oh my God.
Mr. Bexal, Decadent, Ricky Tiki Squad, B. Greg Popovich, Morris Sage, Rich Chestnut, Mahatma Gandhi, not Maccabee, but I got the cucumber. Yo. The juices are pressed, but your boy never is.
Nah.
I am the art, damn it. The Dundada Ganoush, no more cup of noodles, which has a lot of sodium in it.
Mad sodium. It's like 800 milligrams, bro.
I find this out very late.
It's like 90% of your daily intake.
Yeah.
It's really bad for you.
I mean, but then not to get dark.
I feel like if you pour half of the broth out.
No, that's the best part.
Yeah?
The broth.
I'm a noodle guy.
You're a noodle guy. Yeah. I always did the math like this. As a young brown male, my life expectancy wasn't that high anyway. So let me get all this ramen in my 20s.
Why not?
Now I'm 40, got like high blood pressure and shit. Probably going bald, got a sleep apnea machine. But I was like, damn it, those shrimp ones were worth it.
Oh, that shit was hitting.
Yeah.
The little dehydrated peas.
Also, shout out to that one day in your life where you learn the difference between hood ramen and actual ramen.
Yo, you know how long?
I'm like, y'all paying $20 for what?
For ramen? Y'all bugging.
Oh, y'all stupid.
Y'all dumb stupid.
I'll put an egg in this. It's the same shit.
Fam, let me tell you something. I got a 20-pack for $6.
Shit, I'm making it on my Foreman grill.
Stupid.
Cutting up big chunks of ham. That's always a moment, like, some girl comes to your apartment and is like, you can't live like this. I'm like, what?
What are you doing?
What do you mean bed sheets aren't curtains?
What are you talking about? The first time I had the kids in my crib, all I had in my cupboard was adobo.
I'm like, who you be? She's like, I'm not. No, you got to clean your sheets. I was like, I'm Febrezing them.
Yeah,
like,
that's cleaning
come
them.
On. She's like, they're stiff. I'm like, no. Just
no,
folding them.
Just like, you got to just
you
shake
them. You break
them
like a tray of steak. the Prince of Peck of the Fashion Nova Castle, William 8 cents, 5 cents, 10 cent dollar. Forget the small change.
Give me money.
The only anthem I salute is Gypsy. Actually, I've gotten lazy now. I don't even salute that. Like, now I just show up at games late because I don't want no smoke.
Yeah, that's true.
Also, it's the flex if you come to the seats after the anthem. Yeah, people like, already standing.
With two beers.
Fuck that, man.
Oh, the anthem? Oh, y'all playing the anthem? Oh,
also, because I'm a sovereign
beers.
Citizen and I don't respect the United States. And that's why
right.
I pay taxes.
I'm
saying
taxes.
That again.
Fuck
don't
that.
You ever forget. Wesley Sykes taught me. Wesley Sykes is like, boy, you in for big trouble. Mr. Sagan, catch me at square one, top left.
Whoa.
Manager Marv.
Y'all don't cheese me, bro.
Trying to avoid Aubrey. How you let someone named Aubrey bully you? That's a whole other thing. All right. Trio Rizzuto, holy cow. Mr. Soft Palms, all I do is count checks and jerk off. We got OJ Purple Stuff Soda, and it's me, Sonny D. David Uhrman, these expensive Jesus Christ bombs, these bloody shows.
That's right.
That's right. Mm. Smokey, did Cardi and Offset get back together yet? You know what? For a Bronx chick, this is a long time that they've been broken up.
Yeah.
He might be done.
Yeah. It is.
Yeah.
If he gets jumped within the next week, then they're not getting back.
Damn.
Then they are getting back together.
And,
excuse me.
And it's kind of sad because he made an attempt to get her back.
He's like,
I
miss her.
He tweeted, I miss her in all caps. Like, what more you want, Ma?
Yeah.
What like, it ain't Valentine's Day. I got you flowers. Like, you got a tweet.
Come on, you got a tweet. From
he should have pinned the tweet, though.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
What? I mean, what do you expect? The motherfucker got face tattoos.
Of his other kids.
You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
I just throw Offset under the bus all the time because I look like an angel compared to him. So anytime I get a chance, I'm like, yeah, you know, I don't have any of my kids.
I don't have any kids.
I don't have any kids. That I claim.
Until tax season.
Again, sovereign nation, sovereign citizen. Them kids pay for them smells. Yo, shit. So you know Andrew Kuhn and AJ Jr. Energy God Jr. Come sit down, Bobby Charlie.
Yo, sit, Pony, rewind, Pony.
Tommy Petco, because I got your bitch on freeze. The topic of gossip and Syosset. Shout out to the 11791. Anyone here from Syosset? You know what? I ask that question a lot, and I get crickets a lot.
One day.
Syosset don't be out here repping. A.K.A. Grandpa Joe, because when you see Charlie, you see me. Don't touch that golden ticket.
That's right.
Also, here's a new theory about Willy Wonka. Willy Wonka not only was killing people, he was taunting the authorities.
Yep.
Like in Law and Order, the special episodes where Olivia gets kidnapped.
Yes.
Willy Wonka.
Is that guy.
He was like, "What W is what letter of the alphabet?" That was the number of victims he had. That's why he had two W's.
Oh,
Willy Wonka. So
shit.
The next one, he'd be like XX.
Yo.
Y, Y, and Z, Z. He's going around the country killing people.
Damn.
They're going to dig up underneath candy factories and it's just dead kids.
Mad dead kids?
Mad kids. Yo. That's all he was doing. He never was even in it for the candy.
Willy Wonka's a Zodiac killer? Yo, we cracked the case.
He's the BTK killer, but you gotta make it cute. Like the CTK, like confection tickle torture.
Confectionery killer? It's a confection killer!
Yo, your boy Dead Eye Desus. We never got Red Dead Redemption, right?
Yeah. Yo, Roxo, what's up?
Yeah.
Send that.
They're like, just buy it, you cheap bastards.
Yeah, that's true.
I'll probably do that. Mr. Chopper, that's true. These are bad reasons. Like, I'm easy to believe in the black idiot act. Who crack your back like an automatic craftmatic. Mr. Lamarina, Mesh Marina with a fresh misdemeanor and a cold demeanor. AKA your problematic bae.
Yeah.
Don't be afraid to heat your apartment with the oven.
That's true. If you leave the windows open, it's fine.
Listen, all carbon monoxide is good sleeping.
That's right. Forever.
Dark.
The permanent Tempur-Pedic mattress.
Wow. All right. You took it to a next level of darkness that I was just dipping my toe in. But
I jump in the pool of darkness because I am the one, the only, the Kimero, a.k.a. the Human Durant Flap, a.k.a. Donovan McDab, a.k.a. Curve Gotti, you know what I'm saying? Don't come in my DMs, dog, trying to make me say spicy things, a.k.a. Triz Khalifa, you know what I'm saying? A.k.a. Skirt low to jump the curb, hit your fucking bloodhound, nigga, keep it moving out. I don't give a fuck. I spit cold Peter, nigga. I don't care. AKA, I don't fucking Ming. I fucking Ming.
You man.
You know what I'm saying? I Ming.
You Ming.
I Ming. I'm 20 fucking 2 years old.
He gotta be like 25 now, right?
He's like 30.
Yeah.
He's
gonna get sad now.
Imagine when he's like 50?
Hey,
like doing store appearances?
I don't fucking baby.
I don't fucking.
We like, we know you're a 50-year-old Dominican guy.
I know,
it's very sad.
It's actually troubling. You're wearing the old man sandals. AKA, no need to check the guesses and the fucking guesses. I was tourist stunt double in undercover. New York undercover motherfucker. Check my IMDb credits and respect them, stupid. AKA CC Dab Bathia. AKA get into the shmoney and the smoke. It's your boy Goldman Schmidt. You know what I'm saying? Doing all types of fraudulent shit. AKA, I replaced the cast of Seamless with my kids. David never said I got juice, nigga, because I'm the fucking dad of the year. You know what I'm saying? AKA, Ben Smack Biombo. AKA, Diego Maradona. AKA, Dick and your baby Motombo. You don't come on this pussy no more. This pussy belong to me. AKA, David Trisdale. Pow, pow, motherfucker, take that for data. AKA, Bartle Zantana. Mm-hmm. So smooth. I fall asleep at the wheel and crash the zip car.
Sir, please wake up.
Mm. Yo, shit. Oh, damn.
Is this a red light?
Yo, oh.
Go. Cops are here, drive off.
Oh, I'm out of here. Yo, fuck this shit. I jump out the Honda Fit, start running.
The Honda Fit? That's not a real car.
That's not a real car. Shit's a hamster on wheels.
Those are one of those cars that you get offended if your Uber pulls up and it's like a Honda Fit.
You're like, yo, come on, fam.
Come on, man. What are we, the gerbils?
First of all, this is a misnomer because nobody fits in this shit.
Ooh.
You know what I'm saying?
Ooh, T report.
That's right. That's right, big. That's right. That's right, Honda. That's right.
Wow.
Take that.
Wow.
Take that, Honda.
Wow, okay.
I don't want no pilots. I don't want no Accords.
Up next on Watch What Happens Live.
I don't know her. I don't know Honda. I don't know Honda at all. You know what I'm saying? Somebody that bends. AKA Dominican Dundada Dykeman Daddy. AKA swipe my card again. There's definitely money on it. Don't make me embarrass you in front of your fucking management when they come over here and ask for selfies, stupid. You know what I'm saying? I'm a star at the mall, B.
AKA, I'm a star at the mall, B. That sounds like a best-selling shirt in Jersey. Like, I run Trenton.
I run this shit. Yo, AKA Romeo Santos, tu favorito, mommy. So zanny. I'll dry hump your mother on stage at United Palace. I don't give a fuck. Watch me black out. AKA Lightning Dutchy. Hello. Is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes. That your broke ass ain't got five. You know what I'm saying? Can you tell I got a vocal coach?
I see that.
Yeah.
I was like, right. You know what I'm saying? Someone's trying to go to Hollywood.
Happens my vocal coach.
All right.
You know what I'm saying? We are here. AKA Tom Brady, girl, I got my balls deflated. AKA feel that Tyson, damn.
Problematic. Problematic.
Problematic.
Problematic.
Problematic.
Remove. AKA from sequence. It was funny. It was whimsical.
Yeah.
Now it's evidence.
Now it's evidence.
Okay.
You changed from Tyrio to here we go. Mm-hmm. What are we going to change this to?
What's his name? It can't be Phil the Ass Tyson.
Yeah.
It'll be like the astrologer we used to know from the Bronx.
Yeah, yo.
That we never hung out with like that. He was on our show.
He was on our show, but like we don't really bang with him like that. Like, I don't got his phone number. Like, I can't FaceTime him. AKA Lil Snoozy Vert. Yeah, yeah, bitch, I'm on bars. I'm a doze. AKA Final Messi of Gelato. You know what I'm saying? MVP of Gelato. AKA Daniel Bedingfield. I gotta get some sticks. I gotta get some sticks.
Who is brother of whom?
Natasha Bedingfield. It's beautiful music.
I guess
family.
The rest of y'all knew that, but that still shocks me. I was like, wow.
Yo, there's more than one Bedingfields. That's such a British name. I thought everybody in the UK is named.
That sounds like a delicious breakfast cracker. Like,
would you like a Bedingfield? Would you like a Bedingfield with your tea, Sam?
But then they put in like gravy. Like, it's 8 a.m.
Yo, why you put beans on my Bedingfield? You fuck my shit up.
That's how the queen eats it.
Okay. Joe Hooker, I dare you to smoke with me at Mama Sushi. You know what I'm saying? The flagship Mama Sushi on Dykeman. Hello. You know what I'm saying? No. Pay for parking, B. It's only $5. A.K.A. Ben Boston. My hands are gifted. I brought Stan Lee back to life and let him die again just to hear Mike Francesa disrespect his memory for my own enjoyment. I'm not doing shit in the government, so I got time on my hands.
Yeah, isn't he running HUD?
Yeah, he's not doing shit. He's just chilling.
That motherfucker, you know what? He's so detached. He wasn't even... They probably were like, yo, come to these meetings with the Russians. He was like, nah, I'm good.
I'm good.
Candy, don't set the alarm. I'm sleeping in.
There's only 3 people left in this Fortnite Battle Royale. I'll fucking open your medicine cabinet. You know who it is. It's the Zen Man. A.K.A. Rico Sabroso. A.K.A. Lucius Lioness, nigga. Come on. Absolutely not, man. Jasenia, I've gotten blood work over 1,000 times. I'm not scared of no goddamn needles, man. Come on now, man. A.K.A. Baby Newport 2-5, niggas got garbage down the way. A.K.A. Nino Brown, shut the car down. A.K.A. live from the McDonald's at Kingsbridge and Jerome Avenue. It's the East Tremont Stevie B. Doing all his greatest hits like, I wanna be the one your DD is fucking. And Dope Sick Love, just watch me lean. A.K.A. listen, mate. There's no more rock stars left. It's only two. It's the Bodega Boys, mate. I'm coming from across the pond to tell you that I am. The plantain supernova in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Tremont with a bottle of Bugal under my arm. And I'm shirtless. And nice. It's January. And you asking questions.
The nipples is out?
Nipples is out.
Mm.
Cutting glass.
Heavy.
I got the Hershey Kiss nipples. Get ready. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I call bars.
You know what I mean? A.K.A. I met Mike Francis. I'm never going to fail. A.K.A. I'm sitting in my living room waiting for LeBron to call me so I can join the Lakers and be a scapegoat. It's Barmelo's Anthony.
Is he really going to the Lakers?
Bang! He's just chilling in his crib eating Doritos waiting for LeBron to call.
I love it.
Like, for real.
I love it.
Shout out to him. If you see me at Target... smacked off them edibles, staring at Lego Junior sets in amazement, approach me like a fucking Ursine mammal, B. You know what I'm saying? AKA, hey kids, it's Benzo the Clown. Hire me for your kids' party. I'll show up leaning and make balloon animals out of free condoms from the clinic. AKA, I sold fake lean to your favorite SoundCloud rapper. He's high of 409 and ginger beer. You know what I'm saying? AKA, Hasan, tíreme la pita, coño. Dime a ver, cajo de fucking vacinilla. Llegó el hijo de FIFA, coño, el maduro. La verdadera grasa fue Chucky que vino para lo vaso. He streamed all day, pero estoy más frío que Santa Claus en todos los bloques. Llegan a la fucking party. No te quille. Shout out Showtime. Shout out Kasha. Shout out, y como siempre, shout out Lost Me. Shout out DJ Hasan Insane. Es más loco que todo. Shout out Dímelo, el papi de la lady. Shout out DJ Bloquete, el capitán. Shout out Jubilee, la madura. Shout out Vesti. De lo mío llega la grasa que me quité. Ya. Shout out to the whole Showtime crew in the motherfucking building. Motherfuckers on my D.
Pero may I dangle a bacon, egg, and cheese?
Si. Si, papi. You can have it. You can have
it. Por favor.
You can have that, puppy. Enjoy that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, as always, don't forget, we got the show. Greatest show ever in the history of late night television.
That's right.
Returns to TV
February
Thursday,
21st.
February 21st.
Right, 11 p.m.
on what channel? Showtime.
Yeah, do No Nut, extend No Nut November until we debut.
Speak for yourself, sir.
I dare you.
As always, shout out to the sponsors, Square Cash. You know what I'm saying? Keep them checks with the Cash App going.
Yeah, that's right.
What else we got? Anything else we got to plug?
We got a book.
Oh, don't forget, we got the book coming out. Yeah, and right. Mero's First Kids Bar Mitzvah is happening at La Marina in May 5th.
We reopening.
Remember, bottles 200 for two, and we got hookah for babies.
That's right, baby hookahs, y'all.
All right, special live performance of Baby Shark. We out. Woo!